Okay, so we start about the third part, that is part C, which is related to flotation. In this, we have already revised in the previous part the different concepts where the object is able to, the three conditions which were there, the weight of the object when it is more than the maximum buoyant force, what happens when this is greater. I had explained you with respect to the diagram that the whole of the object is going to sink. The weight of the object is much greater than the buoyant force. Barabar hai? So the buoyant force which is acting upwards and the weight of the object is acting downwards. But since the weight is more here, the weight is more, it will sink in the water. Okay? Here also related to density, I explained you when W is greater than F dash B, weight is given by V rho G is greater than V rho of liquid with G. So G, V cancels. So the density of the object is greater than the density of the liquid. Okay, this was already explained to you. Same way, the second case was related to when the weight of the object is equal to the weight, that is the buoyant force. So what will happen is, here again it is going to float, but how much it is going to float? With completely submerged on the free surface, this it is floating at the top level. So this is the diagrammatic part, and here the density of the object becomes equal to the density of the liquid. Getting it? The second part. Whereas the third part, so here it was going to float. With how much part? With completely immersed in water, but at the free surface. Whereas the third case was related to the weight when it is less than the maximum buoyant force. So this time what is going to happen is a small portion of it will be inside the water and a part will be outside the water. So it will be floating with a small portion inside the water, and here the density of the object is going to be less than the density of the liquid, and therefore again it is going to float. Only thing will be with a small portion inside the water and maximum is outside, but here it was completely inside the water. So from this all, what we infer is, what we come to know is, let me have a proper explanation. That is, we have derived the principle, of flotation. What is the principle of flotation? That is, the weight of a floating body, is always equal to the weight of the liquid which is displaced by its submerged part. Here it is completely submerged, so maximum upthrust. The upthrust, the weight is more and upthrust acting will be less. Here a part of it is there, therefore both are equal. Here only a small portion is submerged. So the weight of the floating object, the weight of the floating body is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by its submerged part. Only this much part is submerged, so that much will be the upthrust acting on the body. Getting it? This is the law of flotation. So, this is what I was trying to explain. Let me have a proper space. So, this is about flotation. Have a proper view. Ye ho gaya? Okay. A small part. Now, suppose if we take capital V as the volume of body of density rho S and small v as the volume of body which is floating inside a liquid whose density is L. Okay, so what will happen is, if I find weight of the body which is denoted as W, it is equals to V, capital V, into rho of the solid body into G. Barabar hai? And weight of the liquid displaced, weight of the liquid displaced, that is your buoyant force, is also V into rho into G, but this time it is equal, it will be small v, that is the volume of the body floating inside the liquid, that is the liquid displaced. Therefore V into rho of liquid into G. Lekin for flotation to happen properly, we said that the weight of the object becomes equal to the buoyant force. So if this is so, V into rho of solid into G is equals to V small rho L into G. Only G and G cancels. So if I keep this V as it is, upon capital V is equal to rho of S upon rho of L. So this becomes your formula for finding the portion of water inside or outside the liquid. So we derive that the volume of the immersed part of body upon the total volume of body is equal to the density of the body upon the density of liquid. This will be applicable for fraction type of problems, that is when we are studying how much portion is inside the water and how much portion is outside the water. So this is the derivation where we study about the relation between the volume of the submerged part and the total volume, comparison of the two part, how much part is inside the water and in comparison to the total volume of the body. Okay, so just have a look. Now we proceed with the important give reasons, which are very, very important from examination point of view. Okay, so we now start with the application of flotation, of the principle of flotation, wherein we study how the different objects float or sink in water. Here the first example is related to the iron. Iron in the form of nail, it will sink in water, whereas same iron in the form of a ship, it will float on water. What is the reason behind it? Okay, first is the iron nail sinks as the density of iron. Here you can say that the density is greater. Barabar hai? Aur jis kisi ka bhi density greater hota hai. Let me put up here. Dikh raha hai? Yeah. Whenever the density is greater, it will sink. And the object whose density is less, it will float. Ye ek principle yaad rakho. So iska matlab the iron nail sinks. Why? As the density of the iron is greater than that of water, and therefore it sinks in water. Density is greater and therefore it sinks. Just a simplified version, sinks. Whereas, so what happens when the density is greater? So the weight of the nail, as I told you beforehand, ye sab bataya tha maine, when FB is greater than weight, FB is equal to weight, FB is less than weight of the object. These were the three conditions of flotation and sinking, that is the upthrust. So here what happens? So the weight of the nail, the weight is more than the upthrust. Then the upthrust is denoted by buoyant force, FB. Barabar hai? So the weight of the nail is more than the upthrust of the water. So whenever the weight is more, it will sink. Therefore, it sinks in water. Okay? Now the same principle for ship. Ship is also made of iron, but it does not sink. Why? Because the ship is hollow, empty from inside, and empty space in it is filled up with air. which makes its volume larger. So the volume is greater. We know the formula that density is equals to mass upon volume. They are inversely proportional. When the volume is greater, the density is less. And anything whose density is less will float. Simple? Chalo, isko simple kar dete. So makes its volume larger. Volume is larger. So the volume is greater. And therefore the average density, therefore the density decreases. And whenever the density is less, the object will float. So which is the object over here? The ship. Getting it? So therefore, even when a small portion of the ship, ye pani hai, even when the small portion of the ship is submerged in water, dekho sirf itna portion is submerged under water, the weight of the water, ye jo hai upthrust, it displaced by the submerged part of the ship becomes equal, matlab yahan ka FB becomes equal to the total weight of the ship and therefore it floats. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Give reason, just remember by this shortcuts. Here, first of all, the density of iron male is greater than the water, therefore it sinks. Therefore, the weight of the iron is greater than the upthrust, therefore it sinks. Whereas in case of ship, it is hollow and empty space, contains air, therefore its volume is larger, which makes the density less, and anything whose density is less will float in water. And what happens when it is submerged? Even with a small portion of the ship, which is submerged in water, the weight of the water, ye jitna pani upar aaya hai, because of the weight, Archimedes principle, the weight of the water which is displaced by the submerged part, that is the upthrust, ship becomes equal. The upthrust becomes equal to the weight of the ship and therefore it will float with a small portion of it inside the water. So this is your first give reason. Okay, so the second give reason or a second example of application of flotation is a loaded ship. When it is submerged more, while an unloaded ship is less submerged. Simple reason is the weight of the cargo or the weight of the ship. So when the cargo is loaded, here it's a water. In this, if the cargo is loaded, more portion of it is under the water. This is a loaded one. Okay, a loaded ship. When cargo is loaded on a sailing ship, the weight increases. Here the weight increases. So what will happen? As the weight increases, according to Archimedes' principle, it is going to displace water. So what happens is, the boat which was still here, now when it is submerged, the water level rises and it comes to this level. Matlab this much is the displacement of the water, which is actually the buoyant force, which is actually the upthrust. So here the upthrust becomes this. So what happens is it sinks further. It is sinking further to displace more water. The water is rising up. This is the rise in water level. Till the weight of the water, so that the weight of the water, ye jo weight hai, yani ki force hai, upthrust hai, by its submerged part becomes equal to the weight of the loaded ship, becomes equal to this. Matlab the boat, the ship will get submerged. Kab talak submerge karega? Jab tak iska weight of the ship, of the loaded ship becomes equal to the upthrust of the submerged water, of the submerged part of the ship. बराबर है. नाउ सपोज इसी को अनलोड कर देते हैं, मतलब वेट इसका ऑटोमेटिकली क्या हो गया? कम हो गया. व्हेन द वेट बिकम्स लेस, द सबमर्ज पोर्शन राइजेस अप, मतलब द डिस्प्लेस्ड वाटर विल अगेन ड्रॉप बैक टू नॉर्मल एंड ओनली अ स्मॉल पोर्शन ऑफ इट इज इनसाइड द वाटर, बिकॉज ओनली दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर इज एबल टू बैलेंस, यानी ओनली लेस द लेस अपथ्रस्ट इज रिक्वायर्ड. So when this weight of this ship becomes equal to the buoyant force, upthrust, if the cargo is loaded, is unloaded, now isme saman kuch bhi nahi hai, the ship will rise further in water till the weight of the water displaced, ye jo weight of the water displaced, yani ki upthrust, balances the weight of the unloaded ship. Getting it? The only thing to remember was, here the weight is more and the upthrust also becomes more, and therefore both of them balance each other. Here the weight is less, therefore the buoyant force also becomes less, and therefore they balance each other.
Therefore, both the cases, they are able to float. Only thing will be more portion of it is submerged inside the water. Here, only a less portion of it is submerged in water. Okay? This is about loaded and unloaded ship. Okay? This we have already studied in the previous chapter. That is, a ship begins to submerge more as it sails from seawater to river water. The only simple reason is here the river water has low density. Here the density is less and here the density is more. I told you, when the density is more, it will sink. And when the density is less, it floats. So when, what happens is, when it is sinking, it becomes difficult for the ship to move. When it is floating, it becomes easier for the ship to move. So that is why river water has low density than that of sea. Okay. Now the density of water is also different, of different sea is also different. Why? Because of the salinity, saltiness. As the amount of salt increases, the density increases. Iske liye it is said that the density of water of different sea is different. But here we are dealing with sea and river. So kya karenge? When a ship sails from a sea which is having higher density to a sea of lower density, is sea ke jagah par river le lo, ya fir moving from sea to river, moving from sea to river, what happens is, because the density goes on decreasing as it is moving from sea to river, the density becomes less and therefore it sinks further. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Simple reason, khali itna hi reason de do, because the density of the river water is less and the density of sea water is more, therefore it floats and therefore it sinks. It is difficult for the ship to sail. Here it is easier for the ship to sail. Getting it? That is about the ship when it is moving from sea water to river water. Yeah. So now we study about a plimsoll line. There is a special line called plimsoll line which is marked over the ship. Here, what is the application behind it? Now when the ship is loading, as we saw in the previous give reason, where it is moving from sea water to river water. Okay? So here, what happens is, when the ship is unloaded, for example, so only this much portion of it is submerged. Okay? But as it goes into the sea water, the density increases and more portion of it is submerged under water. But when the ship was not yet into the sail, what happens is, when we are loading it, how much should it be loaded? How much it should be loaded when it is over the water? How much it should be loaded? It is decided by a special line called as a plimsoll line. मतलब ये line पहले से बनाया हुआ हुआ है कि इसके पानी के यहाँ तलक आने तलक उसको load नहीं करना है. उसके नीचे तलक ही load करो. मतलब load करते जाओ और ये plimsoll line है तो उसको इतना load करो जा ताकि इतना ही पानी इतना ही लेवल सबमर्ज हो. क्योंकि व्हेन दिस शिप द सेम शिप व्हेन इट इज गोइंग टू मूव अहेड व्हाट विल हैपन इज एज इट एंटर्स इनटू द सी वाटर वो ज़्यादा उसका डेंसिटी कम हो जाएगा डेंसिटी बढ़ जाएगा और वो सिंक होने वाला है और जैसे सिंक होगा तो ये लेवल यहाँ तक आ जाएगा. लेवल यहाँ तक आ गया इसका मतलब देर आर चांसेस कि वो ऊपर भी आ सकता है एंड अल्टीमेटली द शिप कैन सिंक इन वाटर एंड दैट इज व्हाई फॉर अ प्रिकॉशनरी मेजर एक लाइन बनाया हुआ है विच इज कॉल्ड एज अ प्लिम्सोल लाइन. ओके सो वी ट्राई टू स्टडी द प्लिम्सोल लाइन दैट ईच शिप हैज अ व्हाइट लाइन. ये रहा व्हाइट लाइन पेंटेड ऑन इट्स साइड नोन एज अ प्लिम्सोल लाइन. अभी इसका यूज क्या है? दिस लाइन इंडिकेट्स द सेफ लिमिट फॉर लोडिंग द शिप इन वॉटर हुज डेंसिटी इज 10^3 यानी कि 1000 kg/m³. ये नॉर्मल वॉटर का डेंसिटी है. बराबर. नाउ अ शिप इज नॉट अलाउड टू बी लोडेड फर्दर. प्लिम्सोल लाइन के ऊपर उसको लोड करने नहीं देंगे हम लोग. व्हेन इट्स प्लिम्सोल लाइन स्टार्ट्स टचिंग द वाटर लेवल. जैसे प्लिम्सोल लाइन वाटर को टच करेगा उससे ज्यादा लोडिंग नहीं करना है. उससे ज्यादा लोडिंग किया तो वो डीप अंदर चला जाएगा. सो दैट व्हेन इट सेल्स इन द सी वाटर जैसे ये पानी सी वाटर में जाएगा द डेंसिटी विल बिकम मोर. बराबर है. द डेंसिटी बिकम्स मोर देन 10^3 नॉर्मल वाटर. ओनली द पार्ट ऑफ इट बिलो द प्लिम्सोल लाइन रिमेन्स सबमर्ज्ड इन वाटर. Only this lower portion below the line जो है वो पानी के अंदर रहेगा. अगर ज्यादा डंप कर दिया ज्यादा कार्गो ज्यादा लोड कर दिया तो the water will reach above the plimsoll line and there are chances that the ship might sink in the water. Okay? That's the application, the use of the plimsoll line. Okay, so I had explained you about the center of gravity in the previous part. Here it is related to the center of gravity that if an unloaded ship is filled with sand at its bottom, why do we need an unloaded ship to be filled with sand at the bottom? Now what happens is, when the ship is empty, unloaded, what happens is only a small part of it is under the water. Barabar hai? So what we studied was that if the water level, let me make the water level as a plane level, okay, ye water level hai. So only this much portion is under the water, and when I look at this much portion, its center of gravity is the midpoint. Yani ki suppose ye aur ye midline, yani ye raha apna g, center of gravity. Barabar hai? So only the center of gravity, pani to bahut sara hai andar, okay, so the center of gravity is much at a higher level. So it is just only floating, it is not able to balance, or it is not able to get its equilibrium. So there are chances that if there is a strong wind, it might upside down, it might fall upside down. Okay, there is a danger, it can be blown away. So hum log kya karenge, iske andar agar stone vagere kuch rakh denge andar, okay, the stone vagere kuch rakh denge, that stones are called as, stones or sand is called as ballast. Okay, so when I put some this weight into this, so the jaise weight increase hoga, kya hoga, more and more portion will be, some more part will enter into the water, and now the center of gravity kahan par aa gaya, yahan par aa gaya, matlab abhi center of gravity thoda niche aa gaya, matlab more, it can balance the ship now more steadily, and therefore as the center of gravity drops down, kya hoga, the boat is now in equilibrium and is able to balance the ship, and therefore it becomes easier for the ship to move or to sail in water. Samajh mein aa raha hai? This same thing inwards. An unloaded ship floats normally. It floats with only a small volume inside the water. This is your small volume. Itna sa hi part under water hai. Abhi tak load nahi put kiya maine. Okay. The center of gravity is higher. Dekhte ho, yahan par hai center of gravity. इतना ऊपर है पानी के एकदम नीचे और थोड़ा सा इधर ही है, इज हायर एंड देयरफॉर इट्स इक्विलिब्रियम इज अनस्टेबल, मतलब द बैलेंस इज नॉट प्रॉपर, सो देयरफॉर देयर इज अ डेंजर दैट इट मे गेट ब्लोन ओवर ऑन इट्स साइड इफ देयर इज अ स्ट्रांग विंड, इफ देयर आर चांसेस ऑफ ब्लोइंग आउट और फॉलिंग. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज, व्हाट वी डू इज, देयरफॉर एन अनलोडेड शिप इज फर्स्ट फिल्ड विद सैंड, यहां पर सैंड और सम स्टोन्स, दिस सैंड और स्टोन्स आर कॉल्ड एज बलास्ट एट इट्स बॉटम, जिससे क्या होगा, शिप थोड़ा सा डीपर जाएगा और उसका सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी नीचे की तरफ आ जाएगा, जी विल बी ड्रॉप डाउन, देयरफॉर दिस लोअर्स द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी, और जैसे सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी नीचे आ गया, इट इज नाउ एबल टू हैव एन इक्विलिब्रियम विच इज स्टेबल, एंड देयरफॉर द शिप कैन सेल इजिली इन वॉटर. तो दिस वॉज अ गिव रीजन रिलेटेड टू इट्स सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी. जस्ट यू कैन रिवाइज द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी पार्ट इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, ओके, जस्ट गो थ्रू इट. Okay, so now in the beginning of the chapter I had told you about the example where a human body can float over the water. Now what are the criteria behind floating? Here the human body can float or swim in water. What is the reason behind it? Now if you see the average density of the body density with empty lungs, when you have not inhaled some air, so your lungs are empty, that time the density is 1.07 grams per centimeter cube. Barabar hai? But the same, the average density of the body with lungs filled with air, when it is filled with air, your body density becomes 1.00, that is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Okay. So now what happens is, when you are supposed to swim, a person can swim with his lungs filled with air and nose and mouth with air, lungs are filled with air, The nose and the mouth has to be projecting outwards. The nose and the mouth has to be projecting outside, just above the water surface, so that the water cannot enter through nose or mouth. Getting it? So at this moment, what happens, because of the density 1 gram per centimeter cube, which is matching with the density of water, the weight of the water displaced, that is your buoyant force. Barabar? Displaced means buoyant force. By him is then nearly equal to his own weight, the weight of the body of the person. So when both of them become equal, the object or the substance floats, and that is why he can swim or float with ease with a very little effort on the water. Getting it? So your main give reason behind it was the lungs, whose density becomes 1 centimeter, 1 grams per centimeter cube, and while swimming, a care to be taken is the lungs are filled with air. पहले गहरा सांस लो, नोज और माउथ को वाटर लेवल के ऊपर रखना है, एंड देन यू कैन इजिली फ्लोट ऑन वाटर. वाई? बिकॉज उस टाइम पे द बॉयंट फोर्स ऑफ द वाटर एंड द वेट ऑफ योर बॉडी बिकम्स इक्वल, एंड देयरफॉर इट बिकम्स इजियर टू स्विम और फ्लोट इन वाटर. हिटिंग इट? सो दिस इज योर गिव रीजन. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट गिव रीजन इज इट इज इजियर फॉर अ मैन टू स्विम इन सी वाटर देन इन river water. Same give reason. Now in sea water, just let me explain you the density. The density in the sea of the sea water is greater than the density in normal fresh water, that is your river water. Okay, so here in this, due to the presence of the mineral salts, the density rho is the density. The density of the sea water is 1.026 grams per centimeter cube. Therefore, it is more than the density of fresh or river water, which is just 1 gram per centimeter cube. So, when you compare the two values, the density of sea is greater than the density of the river. And therefore, only a smaller portion of the body will have to be submerged in sea water. When a smaller portion is submerged, the weight of the water displaced, jitna pani upar aane wala hai, it will become equal to the weight of the body. So it becomes easier to swim in this water. Whereas to swim, to displace the same weight in fresh river water, agar fresh water ke andar agar jana hai, then a larger portion, you have to be dipped larger of the body, will have to be submerged. So kya hoga isme? Therefore it becomes difficult to swim in river water. So from this too, we come to know that it is difficult to swim in river water, whereas it is easier to swim in sea water. Why? Because the density is greater. Barabar hai? Same is the example of Dead Sea. Dead Sea ka density sea hi hai, lekin Dead Sea uska salinity, jo saltiness hai, wo zyada hai, minerals zyada hai. Iske liye uska density is 1.16. So it is much greater than the normal sea water. So since the density is of the sea water is about 1.16 gram per centimeter cube, therefore the man can easily swim in Dead Sea. Barabar hai? So that his submerged body part is able to be equal to the total weight of the body. Getting it? Just to mention, in short, the sea water density is greater than the river water, and therefore the person can swim easily in sea water as compared to the river water. Okay, now we look at the principle of the submarines. In case of submarines, what happens is, let me have a proper submarine is somewhat like this, where the front portion and the back portion has an empty space called as a ballast. Okay, it is an empty space, and at the center they have the chamber through which there is a periscope, so that the person can have a proper view. Periscope. Okay, so what happens is, when the submarine, here a submarine is a fish shaped, it's mentioned in the textbook, is a fish shaped watertight boat provided with several ballast, front and the back portion, or flotation tanks. These are called as flotation tanks in front and the rear or the back portion. Okay, it is provided with a periscope so that the diver could see above the water surface even when the submarine is well inside the water. Now how does it move, inside or outside? It is everything based on the principle of density. Let us see. A submarine can be made to dive into the water or rise up to the surface of water as and when desired. Kabhi, if a submarine is to dive, a submarine ko, if you want to sink it down, agar usko niche leke jana hai, what we do is, its ballast tanks, these empty tanks are first filled with water. They are filled with water. Jaise uske andar water fill up ho jayega, it will become heavier. And heavier means the density, the average density of this boat. Boat bol raha hu main. The density of this boat will become greater than the density of the sea water. Barabar hai? So when the density of the boat becomes more than the density of the sea water, it is going to sink. Barabar? The boat can sink in water.
अभी सेम बोट को जब ऊपर लाना है, व्हाट वी डू इज वी इफ द सबमरीन इज टू राइज, अगर उसको ऊपर लाना है, वाटर फ्रॉम दिस इज रिमूव्ड आउट, द वाटर इज रिमूव्ड आउट एंड कॉम्प्रेस्ड एयर इज फोर्स्ड इनटू द टैंक. नाउ इन दिस देयर इज एयर, इन दिस देयर इज एयर, सो व्हाट विल हैपन इज इंस्टेड ऑफ water, now it is air. So what will happen is the density of the boat will become less than the density of the seawater. So when the density becomes less, it is going to float. So therefore, it rises up to the top. So this is the principle behind the submarines, when it is able to sink and when does it float. When it has to sink in water, it is the chambers are filled with water so that the density becomes more. When it has to rise up, the water is removed from the tanks and it is filled with compressed air so that the density of this boat or the submarine, it becomes less than the density of the seawater and therefore it starts floating. It comes to the surface. Getting it? This is the principle of submarines. Now, the next part is about the iceberg. About the iceberg. Now, when you consider iceberg, there are two things. The density of the ice and the density of the water. The density of the ice is 0.917 grams per centimeter cube and that of density of water is 1. So you can see that the density of ice is less than that of water. So when the density of ice is less, it is supposed to float. And that is the reason huge masses of ice, this huge masses of ice are known as icebergs. They are able to float on water with their major parts inside the water. Major part is inside the water. And only a small portion is above the water. That is the principle of iceberg. We'll revise something, some give reasons related to icebergs. Okay, so the first give reason related to the iceberg is the icebergs are dangerous for the ships. The simple reason is icebergs are lighter than the water. I told you previously, that is, density of ice is less than the density of water. So the icebergs being lighter than water floats on the water with major portion, that is the major portion, that is about 90% of it is inside the water and only a small portion, 10% is outside the water but 90% is below the water. Now therefore the portion of the iceberg, the portion of the iceberg above jo hai na, upar bhi hai aur andar bhi hai, it depends on the density of the sea water. Barabar hai? It depends on the density of the sea water and therefore kya hoga? The divers, for the driver of the ship, it becomes very difficult to estimate ki andar kitna portion hai aur kahan par hai. It becomes very difficult to estimate the size of the iceberg. And therefore, an iceberg is very dangerous for the ship as it may collide with the ship and can cause damage. Samajh mein aa raha hai? Simple reason kya likhna hai? 90% inside, 10% is outside and since it depends on the sea water, it becomes difficult to estimate the size of the iceberg. Okay, so the next give reason is about the there is no change in the level of water on melting a floating piece of ice. But already, as I said, when it is floating, this floating below it, the lower portion, when it was submerged, it has already given rise to the water level. So whenever the ice melts, what happens is it starts contracting by volume. But the contraction of the volume of the water, volume of the water becomes equal to the ice volume of the ice piece above the water surface while floating on it. Matlab ye jitna bhi melt hoga, it is already given by this level, which is already the volume which is displaced by the floating part. Therefore, when it contracts, whenever the ice melts, it contracts by the volume, which is equal to the volume of the ice piece, which is above the water surface while floating on it. Barabar hai? And therefore, you will see no change in the water level on melting a floating piece of ice. Matlab, already it has covered up the space. When it is floating, it has already covered up the space. Ye jo rise in water level hai, wo already pehle se hi cover kiya hua hai. So when it melts, it covers the same portion, which is equal to the upper portion, the volume of the upper portion. Getting it? That is why there is no change in the water level.
Okay, the next is about the flotation of the fish. In case of a fish, it is similar to that of the, it has some bladder, a bladder, you can see an empty space inside its body, a swimming bladder. It is called as a swim bladder. It acts like a ballast tank, as I explained in the submarines. Okay, usi tarah se kaam karta hai. Whenever the fish has to rise up, kya hota hai? It diffuses the gas from its fluid, either aju baju or whatever fluid it has taken in. वाटर जो भी लिया था उसके अंदर का गैसेस, दैट इज ऑल द गैसेस गेट डिफ्यूज इन टू द ब्लैडर. जैसे ही गैसेज गेट डिफ्यूज इन टू द ब्लैडर, द वॉल्यूम इंक्रीजेस. जैसे ही ब्लैडर के अंदर वॉल्यूम इंक्रीज होगा, उसका डेंसिटी डिक्रीजेस, एंड एनीथिंग हुज डेंसिटी इज लेस, इट राइजेज अप. सो दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल वाई द फिश कैन राइज अप. नाउ वेन द फिश हैज टू कम डाउन, वॉट इट विल डू इज इट एम्प्टीज इट्स ब्लैडर. ये जो भी गैसेज है, दे आर थ्रोन आउट. They are thrown out. So this becomes empty. This is now empty. And because of emptiness, the volume decreases. Volume jaise decrease hoga, the density increases. And anything whose density is less will sink in water. So this is how it comes down. So the principle, because of the swimming bladder, it can either fill the bladder or empty the bladder. When it want it, it has to rise up, it fills the bladder with air. Or with gases. Now when it is filled with gases, its volume increases, which decreases the density, and whenever the density is less, it rises up. Similarly, when it has to come down, it empties its bladder. So when the bladder is empty, the volume decreases. Volume decreases, which makes the density to increase. And whose density is less, when the density is greater, it always sinks to the bottom. That is how it comes down to the bottom of the pond, sea, lake or anything. Getting it? Now something related to the flotation, that is related to balloons. I had already explained you about the helium and the hydrogen balloons. When a light gas like hydrogen or helium, their density is much less than the density. So the density of these gases is much less than the density of air. When the balloon is filled with such type of gases, the weight of the air displaced by the inflated balloon, that is the upthrust, becomes more. The upthrust is much more as compared to the weight of the balloon, and therefore the balloon rises up. This I have already explained you in the first part. Okay, and there is one more thing. A balloon does not rise indefinitely. Why? Because we studied in the previous pressure chapter that the density of the air goes on decreasing at higher altitude. At higher altitude, the density goes on decreasing. When the density goes on decreasing, the upthrust decreases. The upthrust goes on decreasing. But when it is at this point, for example, the upthrust is acting. Here the upthrust is greater than the weight of the balloon, and that is why it is rising. Barabar hai? But as we go up, at higher altitude, what happens is the upthrust becomes equal to the weight of the balloon. And when the upthrust becomes equal to the weight of the balloon, it will stop rising further. That is the reason why the balloon does not rise indefinitely. वो continuously ऊपर नहीं जाएगा, क्योंकि एक altitude पे ऐसा आ जाएगा where the upthrust becomes equal to the weight of the balloon, and therefore it stops rising up. Okay, so this is the end of your explanatory part, that is your give reason and the whole of the chapter. Okay, just have a proper revision of this give reasons and the numerical part. Okay.